In this video, I will deal with extensions of an iOS application. An extension is an extra for your application. It's executed by iOS independently from the main application and in a separate confinement. It allows you to access to some information in the application without running it. For example, a typical application is Meteo. You can have an extension that just provides you the current temperature without accessing to the Meteo that provides all the evolution of the temperature within the day, etc., etc. It requires the application to be installed and it disappears if you uninstall the application. You have lots of types of extensions. The most used is the today extension. It's a rabbit update in the notification center, as for the example I gave you. You have the share extension that posts something to share content. You have action extension to manipulate or access to the application content. You have photo editing to edit photo and video, in fact, to create new filters for such editing, and you have the custom keyboard to replace the current keyboard by another one that will be accessible to any application in the system. And you have a few other types that have been introduced more recently. Just have a look on the fantastic manual for it. So the extensions in iOS is that, okay, you just drag the screen to the left, and here you have some information. Each of these are extensions. Some are Apple built-in, some other are not. And of course, here you can also add or remove some extensions. So these are where at least all the today extensions go. It's very convenient. Let's have a look on the way we create new extensions in the system. So the idea is, in fact, to create a new target. You always have in your project the main target, the one that corresponds to your application. And here, I will create a new target, and you have a lot of extensions you can create. Here, I will decide to select the today extension. And I give it a name. And you see that now I have a new target and I have here a new folder with files in it. And by default, a storyboard. Okay, you don't see it because my screen is... okay, but you see it. And you have a view controller inside too. That's it. And now you can play and program your extension. To illustrate this, we will use a simple extension, the today extension. These are the easy ones. And the idea is it's handled in a UI view controller that is in the extra target you have created. And this controller has to answer this protocol, NC widget providing protocol. You have a main method here that is invoked when the extension is called. Okay, you have the Objective-C name and the Swift name, and that may allow you to call a handler, which prototype is defined here. We will have an example later. And you also have a few other methods. For example, you want to check if the display mode has changed, maybe because the terminal has changed its orientation, something like that. In some terminals, you can have some changes. Or also, you can have information about the status of the extension that you can basically provide. For example, you can say there are new data, so it means that update will be later required, or no data, that never do any update, or it failed. Maybe because you need to access the internet and you couldn't. So you may have something special that is displayed. By the way, in that example, NC widget providing is related to the notification center. Let's have a look on the extension I want to create with you. It's just an extension that shows time. So I'm happy, I've seen time, so I can go do something else. And if I come back, of course, I want this time to be updated. That's quite simple. Let's have a look on the storyboard part. So here you have your project. We saw that already. In this project, you have the extension part, the extension target, and you have this controller, and of course, you have your storyboard. So it's, in fact, highly recommended to use storyboard, despite the fact that apparently you can do programmatic construction also. Here, I did it in a very simple way, and I was even so simple that I just used the default layout provided by this extension when the target is created. I didn't change anything, but you can add, of course, labels, images, or whatever you want. So let's have a look on the 2D view controller .swift. So here I have made a reference with storyboard to the label. Here, these are comments that which created when I created the extension, so I just left them as is. Here I create a DAT formatter, I specify a DAT format, and I just said that please check the date and display it on the extension. That's all, in fact. Okay, and here I said, okay, this is data that is not fixed, so if you reinvoke this extension or if something changes, please do the update. That's all. You mentioned that I didn't even put anything in the view controller of the main application because it doesn't mean anything. The application just embed this extension and I want it for its extension only. So it's quite easy. Now you can easily enrich your applications. However, you have to be cautious because there were lots of problems with Apple's policy for extensions. And apparently only limited interactions are permitted, and there were rejected applications by Apple and people screaming about that and arguing it was not fair. Apparently you have to be very careful if you are using buttons in these extensions. For example, a guy had a calculator, a small calculator in the extension, his application was rejected, etc. So you have really to check carefully what you can do and what you cannot do and check for the history of the application that were rejected for this reason. But if you just do some simple display in your extension, there is no reason that Apple discard your application, unless of course you put nude things or pieces of nude breast or you know, these highly hot contents that Americans don't like. Thank you for your attention. See you later.